Okay, so we are going to be coding the persistent data project in Unreal Script. And to write the Unreal Script, I'm going to be using the Microsoft Visual Studio 2010 editor along with the nFringe plugin. Now, you don't have to use these tools. You could, for example, use some other text editor and compile the code manually using the UCC, the Unreal Code Compiler. But in any case, I'm going to be using these tools. I'm not going to detail how to install them or how to configure them. This information is already explained in other text-based and video tutorials. I'm just going to get started at creating our project. Our project will require us to create three separate classes. The first class is going to be an actor class. It's going to be the class that represents the cube object that we are going to spawn. The second class is going to be what I call a game state class. This class will save and load the information of the level to and from files on the hard drive. It will contain the actual code that will save and load data. And the third and final class will be a game info class, an overall manager class that will actually initiate the spawning behavior, that will spawn the cubes, the class that will initiate the load and save behavior, that will coordinate these functions to work together. It will also contain the exec functions that we will call from the Unreal console. So the first class I'm going to create will be the cube actor class. I'm going to create this by right-clicking on the classes folder here in the Solution Explorer. When I do this, a context menu appears. I'm going to select Add and New Item from the context menu, or I could press Ctrl+Shift+A on the keyboard. When I do this, a dialog appears, and from this dialog, I'm going to select Unreal Script File. This will create a new and empty source file in which I can create my class. I'm going to name the class down here in the name text field, and I'm going to name it Cube Memory, and then press the Add button on the dialog here. So we have class Cube Memory, and right now it extends from the object class. Now, I don't want it to extend from that because the Cube Memory class is going to be an actor. So I want to extend from the actor class. So I will amend it like so. Now, the next section we're going to be working on is the default properties section. And we're going to be using this section to add several components to the Cube Memory actor. We want the Cube Memory actor to have a cube static mesh to represent its body. And we also want to give it what's called a dynamic light component or a light environment component. And this will allow the cube to be lit correctly under dynamic lighting. So let's get started at doing this. Now, I don't want to spend too much time creating the cube class because it's not the main focus of this tutorial, which is on how to save and load data. But on what I'm about to add to this class, some explanation is required, I think. In the default properties block of this class, I'm going to add what are called components. Now, the Unreal Script language is primarily an object-oriented language, but for actors, it also supports what is known as the component-based paradigm. And what that means is that I can insert or plug in add-ins into the actor class to give it a particular set of behaviors. These add-ins or parts are called components, and I can add as many components as I want to an actor. And each component is responsible for a particular set of functionality. I'm going to be adding two separate components to the actor. One component is going to be a static mesh component. This component will ensure that the actor has a physical body or presence in the level. It will make the cube look like a cube. It will give the cube its faces, its vertices, and will make it visible in the level. The second component is going to be the dynamic light environment component, and this component will make sure that the cube actor illuminates or appears illuminated correctly under dynamic lighting. So the first component I'm going to add to this default properties block is the dynamic light environment component. Now these components are declared using what is known as the sub-object syntax. This refers to a set of commands and functions and syntax that the Unreal script language offers us to declare or to add these components to a class. So I'm going to type begin object. This begins the declaration of a component. Going to say that it's going to be a component of type dynamic light environment component. And I'm going to give this component a name. This is a user defined name, so I can call it whatever I want. I'm going to call it LE for light environment. I'm going to end the declaration by typing the closing command end object. And between the begin object and end object statements, I can add or specify a variety of properties that apply to this dynamic light environment component. I'm going to be adding two properties. The first property is going to be B enabled equals true. This property will ensure that the dynamic light environment component is enabled. The second property is going to be B synthesize SH light. This property will ensure that the lighting that is applied to this actor will be high quality lighting. I'm going to set that to true as well. Now, though we have declared the component that is going to be applied to this actor, this component is not officially added or added in or inserted into the actor until we use the statement components.add and we specify the component to add by name, in this case LE, and close parenthesis. Whoops, no, I don't want that. One second. LE and close parenthesis there. And now that dynamic light environment component has been both declared and added to the actor. The second component I want to add is the static mesh component. So let's go about creating that now. So the static mesh component will be added to this cube mesh using the same sub-object syntax that we used to add the dynamic light environment component. I'm going to add the static mesh component by typing begin object class equals static mesh component. I'm going to enter that instead of dynamic light environment component, and I'm going to give this the name of base mesh, and I'm going to close the statement with end object. We have now completed at least the skeleton of this declaration for the static mesh component, but I need to define some properties between the begin object and the end object here, some properties that will apply to the static mesh component. Chief among these properties is the static mesh property. This property defines which mesh, which static mesh among all the static meshes in the content browser will be used for this actor. Luckily enough, the UDK comes with a cube mesh by default. Anyone who downloads the UDK will get a copy of this mesh, and it is available in the content browser. And this is the mesh that I'm going to use for the cube actor. I'm going to specify this by typing static mesh equals, and on the right hand side of the equal sign, I want to specify the complete name to this static mesh. Now, I happen to know what this is, so I'm going to type it in, but if you don't know what it is, but you can find your mesh in the content browser in the UDK editor, you can get the full name of the mesh by right-clicking on the static mesh in the content browser and by selecting copy full name to clipboard. And you can paste that into the code editor here, and that will work fine. So I know that it is static mesh engine meshes.cube. That is the full name there. Now the next property I want to specify is the light environment property. And this really is just a way of telling the static mesh which dynamic light environment component we're going to be using for the static mesh. And we've already created one here, which is LE. So I'm going to specify light environment. You can see it here in the code completion list. I'm going to select light environment equals LE, since LE is the name of our light component. Now, the next two statements I want to add are related to shadows. I want my object, my cube mesh, to cast shadows and to cast dynamic shadows. So I'm going to add the statement cast shadows equals true and be cast dynamic shadow equals true. Now that then completes our cube actor. We could of course add some specifiers up here such as placeable and class group if we wanted to make this cube actor placeable in the level via the level editor. That is, if we wanted this cube mesh to show up in the actors panel of the content browser to allow the level designer to drag and drop this actor in the level. In this case, I don't really need to add that because we're going to be spawning instances of this cube actor into the level via a console command, the spawn cube command, and we're going to be creating that later. So we're all good to go with the cube actor now, and two classes just remain to be coded, and we're going to be coding those very shortly. Whoops, actually there is just one more line to add. We have to make sure that we add the static mesh component to this cube actor. We're going to do that with the components add statement base mesh. There. Now we have added both the dynamic light environment component and the static mesh component, and now we really are done with the cube mesh.